I long to be back in the war. That was my true home. We were inhuman beings. Butchers on a field full of corpses. Corrupt and depraved. Only some of viscera, blood and bone. Creatures without souls. I was flown back to France to blow up a gigantic fuel depot, which the Germans had built in a bunker on the Maginot Line. The Reich was running out of oil. They guarded every barrel like the crown jewels. The main entrance was secured like the Führer's bunker. Fortunately, every rat's nest has a second entrance. I had to try and find it. I jumped over a wooded area that bordered on the rear of the complex. Unfortunately, my equipment was stuck at the top of a blasted tree during the landing. To make matters worse, I saw that the area was guarded by Waffen-SS troops. Those units had one basic rule: take no prisoners. Exactly like me. I could easily take the soldier out of the way. I only had to be careful creeping up on him. I had to wait until they separated.
Na, endlich mal wieder frische Luft lassen. Sagst du's? Mal kotzen.
Der Luft dort ist kaum auszuhalten. Wo ist eigentlich Hammer?
Der ist vorn und bewacht die andere Brücke, falls er überhaupt noch was peilt. Der ist schon wieder sternhagelvoll.
Kein Wunder. Was der erlebt hat, ist nicht so leicht zu verdauen. Ich vertrete mir noch ein bisschen die Beine.
Mach das.
The first step was done. I was finally in the bunker. The fuel depot was certain to be in the lowest level to protect it from bombing raids. The mishap with my lost equipment would not stop me, but without explosive charges, the situation was hopeless. But the Germans were sure to have explosives stored somewhere in the bunker. Soon they would see what they were good for. A German fuel depot and an explosive charge sound like a very promising combination. The problem was I had to be back outside before this rendezvous developed chemistry. Lockers like this often had useful things in them. careful, broken fragments. Creeping silently over that was impossible. Letters often contained useful information.
Dear Gretchen, my thoughts turn constantly to how you are doing. Please don't worry about me. Even if so much as...
Very interesting. Good use of the mask. Somehow I should be off now. Very nice. That would do to blow up the fuel depot. That was the fuel depot. The room was full of poisonous fumes. In addition, there were explosive barrels everywhere. If firearms were used, everything could go up in a bang. Now I had to find a right place for the bomb.
Who's gemeiner Dieb?
Meine Güte, fängst du schon wieder an? Ein gottverdammter Dieb bist du. Den eigenen Kameraden Waffenbruder bestehlen. Das ist das Letzte.
Mann, jetzt hör aber mal auf. Ich hab gar nichts geklaut.
Du hast von meiner Schokolade gegessen. Du Dieb!
Vielleicht ist es ja der Obersturmbannführer gewesen.
Von wem? Du hast wohl gedacht, ich merke das nicht, was? Aber da hast du falsch gedacht. Lass mich zufrieden. Auch noch frech werden, was?
Soon it would resemble a cemetery.
In France, there was a man whom I'd always wanted to meet. Colonel Willy Schunzel, better known as the Butcher of Paris. It was no wonder that he was at the top of the list. It is just that so far no one had succeeded in coming close to him. We had learned that Schunzel wanted to see the looted art and the cathedral. As ever, he followed the siren call of gold. It was reported that every entrance to the interior of the cathedral was blocked, except for one door which led down into the crypt. However, the entire area was heavily guarded. I had to keep my eyes open, but an opportunity always arises. The House of God. Schunzel, where are you hiding? What are you praying for? Forgiveness of your sins?